This is Dan Terrace. Hello. I'm with the BioVideo Center, and I'm here with Kiran, who's a well-known entrepreneur from India. Hi, Kiran.
Hi, Dan.
Tell us about BioIndia. There seems to be a lot of interest in spin-offs from this type of a meeting.
Well, you know, this is the third edition of BioIndia, and you can see that it's gaining a lot of momentum and a lot of visibility because I think the India biotech story is unfolding very rapidly. And we are getting to see very interesting companies sprouting in India in the biotech space across very diverse sectors in biotechnology, you know, ranging from biopharmaceuticals to biofuels to enzyme companies to agri-biotech companies. So it's a very, very exciting time for India. Actually, you know, the biotech sector in India has been growing over the last decade. And it is now beginning to reach critical mass. You know, many companies are scaling up. So I think that's why the whole India biotech story is becoming very visible on the global scenario.
Now, Kiran, you're a role model in India for what you've accomplished. Would you have predicted 10, 15 years ago the growth of biotech in India?
I think, to be very fair, I think we did expect this to happen because I think 10 years ago we basically had a pretty clear roadmap. And, you know, we had a pretty clear understanding of what it would take to get there. We predicted this the size of this segment to be about $5 billion, and that's exactly where we are today. So we've been pretty accurate about forecasting. But I think the potential is much greater. Mm-hmm. And I think today the Indian government is enabling that growth in a much more robust way. I think they're putting into place a lot of very good incentivized programs, funding, and doing a lot of stuff which really will propel growth in this sector.
So this meeting, this bio meeting, is obviously a template for what you're doing. Do you see the same kind of partnerships developing? I mean, that's obviously the strength, one of the strengths of this kind of program. So you hope to attract an international people coming to this?
I think the very purpose of BioIndia is to provide an international platform and for partnering discussions. And I think it has been very successfully achieving that over the last two editions. This year should be much bigger, and there should be far greater interest in what's happening in India, because 2 years ago it was in its nascency. I think today you're seeing a lot more happening in India. There's a lot more interest in India. And I think India as a market itself is very attractive.
Yes.
So I think when you put everything into context, emerging markets, India, innovation, biotech, that whole combination is very, very exciting. And I think we expect this year's BioIndia to be a big success.
So tell us when this meeting is and where.
It's in Mumbai on the 12th and 13th of September. And we just hope that everybody gets to Mumbai on those two dates.
So maybe you should have Fareed Zakaria as a tour guide and fill up a 747 heading to Mumbai.
Well, Fareed Zakaria is a Mumbai man. So, you know, no surprises if he happens to be there on the 12th and 13th of September.
I think what everyone is impressed about India is what Fareed has been talking about, and that's the entrepreneurial spirit despite government.
That's true, but I think, you know, government has been playing a very enabling role in biotechnology. And
well,
you know, biotech is one sector that unfortunately can't do without regulation in some form. But I must say that at the moment the government of India is very supportive, and I think biotech is going to be a big growth story for India.
Well, Kiran, great talking to you. It was a pleasure. Thank you very much. This is Dan Terrace for the BioVideo Daily Show. Thank you.